Hi, guys. So, kind of funny and interesting story. I pulled these cards yesterday, Monday, because I had heard about this Volume 5, you know, buzz in the news, and I thought, well, they're probably going to, you know, I was curious, well, is it going to be a big deal? And I thought it would happen when Congress came back from break, like after Labor Day. And so I started the reading and did the intro yesterday evening through the cards. And like I do sometimes, I sort of went and took my walk and had dinner. And I just thought I'll come back to it tomorrow, Tuesday, which is today now. And it turns out they dropped the report. So basically I thought, well, my reading just doesn't really matter anymore because the report came out. We already know what it's about. But then I actually think it's kind of interesting and also tells us something else that's really interesting that might be coming. So stay tuned for the second half after this intro. Hi guys. So I'm trying to get it straight. Like, what are the different reports that we are waiting on that may give us more information into things that we would be interested in? So let's do this. Let's first read on this Volume 5. So Spirit, help us to see, how big is this report? How much will we see this Volume 5 on Russian interference? How big is this? Is this going to be a big bombshell in September that will be a game changer? Or is it going to be sort of same old, same old? So help us to see. Okay, here's what, so it's really funny because this Knight of Wands, it's like I didn't realize they were actually in the process of releasing it the next morning. This Knight of Wands basically is telling us that, like, it's coming out, which is pretty funny. Covered by the Hermit, which I did, of course, when I threw the cards, I did look at them and analyze them a little bit, and I thought, so it's kind of fun to see how right or wrong I was. I did see this as like redactions. Now I do see it also as, okay, I think what it's saying is this is, because, you know, I wanted to know, is it going to be like this big bombshell thing? But this is tells me, like, you got to read, you got to look closely at the details and read closely into it. And that's exactly what people have been doing today. So that's kind of funny. We see on the surface, yes, it's about the stealing of the election. But it's also very much what stands out to me was the stealing of the DNC emails. That's a lot of sort of the main stuff that's interesting in this report, because we're seeing a lot more that was much more tied to the Trump campaign through Roger Stone. So that tells us, basically confirming what we're talking about here. Down at the base, we have the World card. Besides this Hermit card, this is the only major arcana in this. So I was reading it as, like, it's not gonna be earth-shattering, but it's interesting that this is here beneath the surface. And that might tie into what I think is that there's more coming, I think, in another report. I think beneath the surface of this thievery, there is a more complete operation that we get little bits and pieces of, but it's there. It exists, and it's big. So the big thing that we feel exists does exist beneath the surface. The big operation does exist. And I'm getting this world called at the base of a lot of my reads. Like, I don't know. This is simple and interesting to me. In the past, yes, we got the disinformation campaign. That was Mueller's first report. Or, you know, his report, Volume 1 and 2, one of those volumes was just about. So, like, this is what we already did know. What we didn't have as much of, which we do now from this, is the partnership. It's there. And this is what we're getting out of this, even though it takes a lot of, you know, little pieces, it's there. So that is what I was guessing from the report, was that we're going to see more of the partnership. And we do. This is also interesting. Well, this is also funny now that we know it did drop, and it was about to drop when I did through the cards. That's sort of what this is saying, this six of pentacles. It's like the dropping of some information. But it is also interesting because this card also, it's like scraps, you know? I mean, that's a big fish. It's a big fish, but it's sort of like in the traditional tarot, it's like, you know, handing out a little bit to the hungry and poor. And that's us, right? So we got a fish in this report. It's not a total, just like the Mueller report. They're both big and they're both important. They're both good. It's just that we haven't had that moment. So, and this card upsets me because it's true. That what a strange time to drop this report, right? First, Congress isn't even there. It's like everyone's on a vacation. It just gives the impression that this isn't very important information to Congress. And also, we're in the middle of the Democratic National Convention. I mean, what a time to drop this story when people are taking a break from this normal news. So that upset me a little bit. And I think there's some truth to that. That was like the first thing I thought. Like, they're dropping it right now on a Tuesday morning during the convention. Ugh. Hopes and fears. I felt this to be this Five of Cups. This is loss. And I think, you know, I think we feel this a little bit. It's like, why doesn't it matter? There's, first of all, like, it does matter, but it's just nothing ever feels like quite consequential enough. And I feel like almost the people who wrote this report feel this also, that it's just going to get spilled and like mixed in with everything else. Like, you see this water spilling and then this giant river. It's just like another, it just keeps getting spilled into that. But it's interesting because these two cups here are not spilled yet. The long term I got outcome was this Two of Pentacles. I thought it was very interesting that I got two twos here in the outcome. It's really pressing down on the collusion with these twos, I believe. And the fact that this is what we got today. And that's interesting because that was like the shorter term outcome. This is the longer term outcome. I just think we're gonna get more. At this time I did look at the bottom of the deck and I saw a little story here. I thought of Paulie Manafort. For some reason in my head, he's Paulie Manafort because he's like this mobster. It's really what he is. He's not this political guy. So we've got like Paulie Manafort and Roger Stone and these kind of just, I felt the like underbelly of the campaign working to do this dirty work. Yeah, to create this event to put Trump in the White House. It's the group. And we do definitely, it's interesting because we do definitely see that in this volume 5. You see a lot more of the communications between the dirtbags doing the work to get their boy in office. This is a lot of times my like inauguration card, and it's kind of like, or like a White House card. And I keep wondering, something's got to come up with that inauguration. That's got to come up at some point. And then King of Swords, I wondered on this for a while and I realized this is Assange. So, yeah, they all worked to get Assange to do his thing and put their boy in office. So there's that little story. And then I wanted some clarifiers, of course, on this Two of Wands. And I got a King of Wands, a Three of Wands, and a Queen of Wands. Look at all these wands. That's a little wild. And I'll tell you what, a lot of times for me, wands are like a ruling. Like, you know, I imagine a judge going phew with his gavel or her gavel. So maybe there's more judgment coming. So, yeah, so again, more of the collusion and the sort of, you see the little globe there, the world taking over the world. I feel oil in this again. There's gonna be eventually, I don't know if it's gonna be this year, but at some time we're gonna understand the oil connection for sure. I mean, they are oligarchs, right? And Trump just does all this work to deny global warming or, you know, move our progress our country forward in any way. In that way, he wants to reverse everything to serve his guy. And we have a King of Wands. Okay, so This is total, like, overseas, waiting for help overseas. What I think this is, okay, so as I'm watching this back in editing, these cards, I'm getting these cards so much more clearly. This King of Wands with this Three of Wands. The King of Wands being someone, and I'm getting so much heat in my head on this. So I feel like that's really, this is really it, is this King of Wands being another world leader who is helping America, like someone we would want to be allies with, who truly cares about America, and also in general, these bad players on the world stage trying to create this criminal power. So that's what I see, like a Justin Trudeau or someone like that. And they will be part of this other report that will help us to see things more clearly. And then on that, this Queen of Wands beneath it all, I would read as possibly Nancy Pelosi being in contact or having a knowing that this is coming, that this is being worked on, or possibly even a Gina Haspel of heads the CIA, considering that the CIA's mission is to collect information related to foreign intelligence and foreign counterintelligence. So that would make sense as well. And so I think that this little story now at the base is telling us more of what we'll get in the second report. I see this to be about America and putting their boy in office, right? Their guy, Donald Trump. So I think that this is telling us about the techniques. Again, I see Putin eyeing our oil. Oh, and by the way, speaking of that oil, Trump just yesterday or the day before announced the Trump administration is going to be opening the Arctic now for drilling. The protected Arctic land is now going to be open for drilling to the highest bidder. And I feel like that's a favor for Putin somehow. I don't know how he's going to get that to Putin, but that's tied in. Such an interesting thing to do in these last 80 days, right? And he did it in such a way that it'll get started and everything will be done before he leaves office so that the Democrats can't, like, take it back. Ugh, unbelievable. So, Six of Wands, the elevation of Donald Trump, of course, to continue as president is what they want. The Five of Wands, the fighting. They want to create division and fighting within the American people to just so that we're all just involved in fighting each other and they can just go ahead and take over, right? Of course. Classic. Divide and conquer. Destroy your enemies. Ten of Swords. Just techniques on how to just destroy anybody who is against you. And I just see that as people in Congress are even finding ways to do this. It's so gross. And I see a lot of that in this Ace of Swords, these conspiracy theories. It's like taking over people's minds. That's part of it. And voter suppression. Find ways to suppress the vote. I feel like this is going to be all in the report. And I feel that when we get it, it will make us feel so validated and feel so much better. This is the miracle that we're waiting on. And, you know, and look at that. Like, then, now we've got the major arcanas. We've got this, well, actually, there's a bunch of them in here. But the Star, Judgment, and the Sun. These are the positive ones, anyway. I just think we're going to feel, and these make me feel better. Like, this is like, this is like feeling like the world is on center again. Because we, we'll understand things better. And we'll be able to, like, really speak to what's going on in a way that will wake more people up because we'll have that evidence there in the report. And it'll feel finally like a new day. We can, like, yeah. So I do feel that new day is still coming. But I think that it'll be another report coming. But that they will complement each other and give us the whole picture. So anyway, I hope you found that interesting. Let me know if anything stood out to you, if you have any thoughts on these reports. It's like, I can't keep them straight. They're making my head spin. But I think I got the facts right on that. And thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys next time. Bye.